Hey, Out Late But Great, this is Jim here from Ohio, and it is Friday, and I am your host on Fridays on the channel Out Late But Great. So anyway, guys, before I get to the topic, I just want to tell you how thankful and happy I am about the crazy thing that just happened in Arizona. For those of you that don't live in the United States, the Arizona legislature passed a very anti-gay bill, and they both houses of the legislature passed it, and it went to the governor and she vetoed it, which I was so thrilled. I really was. I mean, it was a terrible, awful anti-gay bill that would have let people, because of their religion, not serve as gay people. I mean, it was so ridiculous. It really was. And it just felt really, really good to see these bully Republican politicians getting slapped down. And hopefully it sends a message to them and to that party to knock it off, basically, because they're on the wrong side of history, and if they want to survive, they're going to have to start changing their ideas and at least make them to what the mainstream of this country is all about. So anyway, I just had to say that. So I'm really happy. And it got people talking, too. It really did. It really lit up a firestorm in this country. So, anyway, on to the topic. Michelle picked the topic this week, and it is time to get a little culture. What is one of your favorite poems, LGBT or not, and why does it stir your heart and thoughts? If not a poem, pick a song, share the lyrics, and share what it means to you. Well, it's so funny. I have satellite radio in my car, Sirius XM, and there is a channel on there called The Bridge. And it connects, it's called The Bridge because it connects today with older songs from like the 60s, 70s, and 80s. And when I was growing up, I was really into Simon and Garfunkel. I really was. My sister actually got me into it because she's a bit older than me. They really were big back in the late 60s. In early 70s, so I really like them, and I actually got to see them in concert one time in Akron, I believe. So there was a song that they put out there that I just heard on the radio two or three days ago, and it brought back a lot of memories. It really did. For those of you who have watched this, our channel, I didn't come out till I was 30 years old. So basically the whole decade of my 20s, I was completely alone and in the closet, and you know, most of my friends, my straight friends, were busy having kids, and my family too, my siblings, my brother, my younger brother, my sister, so they were busy. So I basically kind of lived an odd sort of sheltered life. I went to work, I went home, I bought an old house and I worked on it. But other than that, I was basically alone. And Simon and Garfunkel wrote this song back in the 1960s. And this song always kind of reminds me of that decade of my life in the closet. So I'm going to read it to you. It's called I Am a Rock. A winter's day in a deep and dark December. I am alone, gazing from my window to the streets below, on a freshly fallen silent shroud of snow. I am a rock, I am an island. I've built walls, a fortress deep and mighty, that none may penetrate. I have no need for friendship, friendship causes pain, its laughter and its loving I disdain. I am a rock, I am an island. Don't talk of love, but I've heard the words before. It's sleeping in my memory. I won't disturb the slumber of feelings that have died. If I never loved, I never would have cried. I am a rock, I am an island. I have my books and my poetry to protect me. I'm shielded in my armor. I'm hiding in my room, safe within my womb. I touch no one and no one touches me. I am a rock, I am an island. And a rock feels no pain, and an island never cries. So, to me, that is what I was doing back then, and it was really so unfair to me that I did that to myself, and that is part of being in the closet. I mean, you You do the craziest things to yourself just to please others. So hopefully, if anybody out there is in that situation, please get out. It's toxic. It really is. So anyway, that was me in my 20s. I can't get them back, but if you're out there and you're at whatever age and still dealing with all this nonsense, please, please help yourself and get out. So that's all I got to say. We are supposed, believe it or not, you know, I hate to sound like a broken record, but we are supposed to get a foot of snow Sunday into Monday. So I am so over this winter. I really am. It has just been horrible. I've never seen anything quite like it. And in, you know, it's funny, the weather is weird the world over. A friend of mine in Ireland says it's been windy and rainy and cold, and our friends in California say they've had more rain in the past couple days than they've had last year. So something is definitely going on with the weather. So anyway, guys, that's all I got to say. Take care, love you, and I will talk to you next week. Bye-bye.